so my poem's called Self-Actualization. Foggy mirrors reflecting the alluring smile. The wave of warmth conveys the picture-perfect image. Silky skin, soft eyelashes, hidden truth. So how many likes will accept us? They believe that an image of a woman should be pretty, skinny, and happy. While the definition of pretty is not the post with 2,500 likes, we won't accept ourselves till we reach that mark. It's a battle of us and them, begging to collide two worlds to create flawlessness. But is this our perfection or theirs? How can we appreciate our smile while duplicating others? Mesh irises just don't fit on the color wheel of beauty. So how many likes will accept us? Lost souls captured by the suffocating air of society. The last sincere smile morphs to dust. The last laugh of joy turns to the laugh of envy. So is there an age where our beauty isn't valid? When do we look in that vivid mirror and decide, this shouldn't be us? 157 million women struggling between gratification and misery. And yes, that includes me and you. The infinite war of reality suctions our minds and burns our souls. So what happened when we were walking through the hollow walls of the comforting home, reaching that candidate image reflecting off the slim glass? We smiled, not that collective smile that we morphed, that genuine welcoming smile. What changed between us and the little girl in the mirror? Is it the reluctant voice in our head that grew up with us, the social media we were exposed to, or the lack of sympathy that was drowning us when we reached for that life buoy? Some secrets are meant to be hidden, but this one is for us. The only difference between us and that hopeful girl is time. We still have her in our mind, and letting her go will be our only crime.
Amazing. And for the scores, we have a 9.4, an 8.3, a 9.1, a 9.8, a 10, and a 9.7.
Not too much. Okay. Hurt is when those who feel oceans can only explain a drop in the water, and countless times I've wondered, where does the ocean end? Every day I'm gently drowning myself, stuck in waves of my own thoughts and the overwhelming feeling of overthinking. It's a mental prison that pulls me into a whirlpool, coiling me in circles with thoughts that don't connect and ideas that are formed from silence. My mind will be the most powerful force that I can battle face to face. It tells me little lies, that I can't do that, that I'm not enough, that I can't go on anymore. It often makes everything much worse than it actually is, but I have to let go. And all I have to do is wander through and thank myself for overcoming it, because the only locked doors are in my own mind and the doors of reality are wide open.
Great job by Elena. And for the scores, we have a 9, a 9.8, an 8.3. An 8.1, a 9.5, and the final score is 8.5.
Physics. All right. I get in and turn the key. The motor barks, growls, heckles, and smacks. I slowly but surely step on the brake. Shift into drive, I slam on the gas, and I'm gone. Switching lanes faster than a coyote chasing the roadrunner, close calls poison me with adrenaline. Speeding by trucks, cars, bikes, people, and police. Red and blue anxiety haunts me till I slow down. But that's the problem, I don't slow down. I'm addicted to the thrill. I'm addicted to the thought of, oh my God, I could have died right there, or here, or a week ago, or even 5 minutes from now. When I touch the wheel, don't be scared or anxious, just have trust. Life is a game, and this is how I choose to play it. What I do is completely idiotic, but I can't quit. It's reckless driving, but I don't call it that. I call it cautiously unsafe. It's therapy for me, but it's also suicide.
Nice job by Cyle, and the scores are a 9, a 9.1, a 9.8, a 9, an 8.7, and an 8.5.